Okay, so let me just try to finish this up real quick without wandering around too much. I'm looking at the basic overall shape. I can do this with hammer, stone, or with this tool. Now there's it. It's rounded on top here. It's pretty flat on the bottom. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start taking flakes off of here to bring this portion down a little bit thinner, which will make this whole thing flatter. And I like to flatten or thin the edges, the ends, first, and then work on the middle. It's stronger that way. Strengthen that platform. I'll just zigzag along the bottom. Good point to strike right here. Brings that down a little thinner, flattens it out. There's still a high spot here. See the best way to attack it. You don't want to attack it from there because there is a hinge right there. So I could attack it from this ridge coming in this way. Set it up a little bit better. What I'm going to do is, I could set it up a little bit better than this, but I'm going to hit right there. Getting too close here. I'm going to hit it right there. And it will follow the ridge, in theory. Unless you get a step. Sometimes you can blow through those steps, sometimes you can't. It all depends on how strong your platform is and how bad those steps are. Bad steps and a weak platform, forget it. Strong platform and weak steps, you got a pretty good chance. And I always try to hit below center line. And sometimes it's hard to tell. But you can see that point sticking out here is below center line. There's not a ridge, but there's a high spot that I can follow. And I'm going to be removing as large a flake as I can across here. Which means the platform has to be pretty strong. Make sure I don't hold it like this and bridge it. Because I don't want it to snap right there. I don't want to take off that flake. Didn't go quite as far as I wanted, but it's good enough. As we get down to finishing the point, we can thin it later. I'm going to move the edge closer to those steps, that way I can get past them. See what I did? I took some off the edge here, so I get right up close to that step, and then grind it. now I'm going to hit right there. Hopefully send a flake in. There's a kind of a ridge here. Now this, you notice how the tool is not directly at a 90 degree like a T to the edge. It's kind of like this. I don't know why it works better that way, but it does. If I'm holding it directly 90 degrees and then I hit, I'm not as accurate for some reason. And maybe because there's just too much surface area. But if you go at an angle like this, you're only using the, I guess it's the corner of that. Puts a lot of force in a small area. That one was better. It's better not to be too aggressive in the beginning and then figure out what you can get away with and then become more aggressive as you move on. Because right now overshots are not something you want, because we're pretty close to the shape that you'll be at the end. You don't want an overshot to go all the way across and take off some of the other edge. You notice I always try to take off whatever I can that didn't come off the first time, these little hinges, because they will stop flakes from traveling. Moving that edge down closer to this mass I want to take off. It's just the opposite for this side. I want to take off this mass. I want to take off that mass. And I'm just brushing. I mean, I guess you could tap it lightly, but brushing works good. If you're not getting flakes like this, don't worry. It took me a year to be able to get thin flakes like that. Where I wanted. I could get thin flakes, I just couldn't get them where I wanted. And see, it creates a nice flake scar pattern. That takes a while to get used to as well. You're not going to get nice flake scars like that probably in the very beginning. It'll look a lot like this here. But it doesn't really matter. The real artifacts were not perfect. As long as the edge is sharp and the shape is right, that's what matters. See what I'm doing, just working my way down. I think you get the idea. Right now I'm just being, you know, opportunistic and taking flakes wherever I can. I'm not preparing the platforms very well. I'm just looking for ones that are already strong. Eventually, when I hit it enough times, it'll be so thin that I'll have to grind it. I try not to do too much thinning from the base at this stage. It's getting kind of thin. But before it gets too much thinner, I think I can take a few more flakes. Oh. without worrying too much. Now this is about, I don't know, 3/16 thick. You can leave it this thick and just pressure flake the rest of it, because right now it's a preform. You could just pressure flake the rest of it. And if I wasn't talking or trying to explain, it doesn't take too long to get down to this stage. And we pretty much covered the whole thing with flakes, with flake scars. There's a little ugly hinge right there, but we can get that later on. I might even be able to get it right now, but just setting up a platform right here, coming in, see if that works. Worked pretty good.